So I'm here today to talk about nanonodes. Before starting to explain what is a nanonode, just let me give you a little bit of background. So there are a lot of challenges in large scale-out systems when it comes to storage. Well, for all large scale-out systems, but storage in particular. So one is scalability, because we need to manage growth. And it was about terabytes, now it's petabytes, and we are just seeing at the horizon the exabyte. It's becoming really, really hard to manage this kind of growth, not just the size at the beginning, but all the things that are happening during the years. And another thing that we look for in large scale system is dollar per gigabyte. We are looking to spend as less as possible. The problem with that is that most of the systems are built out of very large servers, like 60, 90 disks per system. This is a very huge failure domain, which can be now, with the size of the disk that we have, more than 1 petabyte for each single node. And efficiency is another thing that everybody looks for now in large data centers. And I'm talking about power cooling, I'm talking about energy in general, and so on. And last but not least, we want things that are simple, simple to manage, simple to update, simple to automate, simple everything. So this is what is today, but tomorrow is even worse. If you look at what is happening with flash memory, all the vendors are working to put 1 petabyte per rack unit, which is a lot of density for a single CPU. Okay, because then you have to manage encryption, you have to manage erasure coding, you have to manage compression, and so on. And one CPU is not enough. The second is speed, because you have a lot of problems with all this density, with the network connections. Again, the huge failure domain that is created by a single node, 1 petabyte. We are talking about 40 petabyte per rack here. And also the workloads are changing, because we are looking everywhere to have less, to reduce the CPU to data latency, to reduce the distance between the two. Okay, there are a lot of efforts in the industry, like NVMe, for example. We removed a lot of the stack to reach the data from the CPU. Okay, but and we want to do a lot of jobs in parallel, because we are working again with petabytes and petabytes of data. Not all the workloads are meant to work on all of this data at the same time. So, and last but not least, there are new computing models, like, for example, serverless, which is very good, because you can start a function every time that something happens in your storage system. So what is what the industry did was a KV drive, which is a key value store in an hard drive. Okay, you can access this with Ethernet, standard Ethernet, but actually it was a problem more than a solution, because he introduced a new paradigm without resolving really the problem, because you needed, anyway, a central controller to manage all these disks. So what is happening now? There is a new device, and which is pretty nice, because it's a very, very simple computer in front of a standard hard drive. Okay, it access it has a dual core CPU, it has all the features that you need. It exists in several form factors, and it can run standard software. So the benefits are a lot. There is a failure domain, this is one disk. Its power consumption is 3 watts per disk, on top of the disk itself, of course. And it's easier to manage. It's just a disk. You can lose them. Who cares? It's not a large node. Okay, and because it has CPU, it's perfect to run functions. So scalability, that could be a challenge, okay, because the software is not designed to scale a lot. You have an order of magnitude of disks with node more than in the past. Load balancing, same problem. The software has to be designed to have dynamic data placement. And management is another important thing, because you know, automation is even stronger in this case. And the last thing is you, because this is a totally different thing. It's like managing a swarm of devices instead of few fat nodes. So my talk is finished, and I didn't have the time to talk about other application of this kind of devices, but you know, you can reach me out on Twitter if you want, and that's it. Thank you very much.